Hello. Have a speak, Stu. Hello guys, welcome to Wise Jet Productions. Dan Yates, Craig Mallinder, MDPL, this main singles final. Sorry again for the slight delay. Yep, speak, are you getting thing? Speak.
Hello.
You should
hello,
be.
Hello.
No.
We've got a little helper tonight.
Put you in this one. Speak.
Hello.
Hello. Don't seem to be getting any sound from Big Stu. He's going direct, of course he is. Hello guys, welcome to the MDPL singles final. Big Stu's headset is not working, so it's just me on commentary for now. Just gonna get some power. Let us know everything's coming through okay. So hopefully she'll be joining me soon on commentary. Let us know in the comments who you think is going to win this. Dan and Craig poised and ready for this final. Please let us know if the commentary is coming through clear. About to get underway. Please let us know that it's all coming through okay. I can hear on the stream that I'm coming through okay, so let's get a cracking. So let's go to the lag. This is going to be an absolute monster of a match, I feel. Thank you, Josh. Cheers. And Dan Yates wins the leg in this first rack. Don't forget to share our stream. Let's get some more viewers on this top match that's going to happen. Bezel Berryman ref today. We have a helper today, Craig Mallander's little man. He's standing next to us, supporting Craig. So straight open with the break. And you'd say, I'd be going yellows. Straight off the bat, yellows. Dan Dry. Table. He's got a chance, an early chance on red too. Sorry, yellows. On the Reds. Gonna try and get Stu on in a minute because he's dying to talk to you all. Or he's just dying, I don't know which one it is. Craig on the Reds, Dan on the yellows. Straight across, but yeah, for this other red. Just one good shot here to get on that middle red, and it should be 1-0.
Right, hello people, let me know if you can hear me. I've got a new webcam plugged in.
Yeah, unfortunately your headset didn't work, Steve. I think it's legend proof.
Oh, we've got Joshua Fiswas in. You can always count on Josh, can't you?
Always. Number one fan of Josh Chapman's. Playing in a bit of trouble here, because that red is tied up. Dan with a chance to mop these yellows up in the first round. The clump in the middle, you've got the bottom yellow that goes to the bottom right, and then the other two could be left to go. So I don't think you'll have a problem with it. But we'll take a look. Oh, Dan.
Oh.
That's a leash. Just a touch of nerves there, Stuart. What do you think?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, they could have, like I say, harder or softer anywhere, really. Would you have brought it down closer to the yellows? I mean, it looks like he's got a total out of it.
But he's done all right. He's done all right. What I'm actually seeing is a gap. There's a gap for the treble, but not the treble.
Yeah, I think he's up and down on this one.
He's going to have a chance for that, unless he pops it.
I mean,
has he got away with that?
If that's a touching ball.
Oh. Don't forget to share the stream, guys. Let's get some more viewers, because this really is a classic fight. Two top players.
Yeah.
Sound good, Stu, from Chris Byrne. Thank you, Chris.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
During the match, we also have Bill Ray versus Graham Lamb in the MDPL plate final tonight as well. We'll bring you a live update on that in a minute. Plus, we have a camera set up. So we will fit to that as well. People are playing. No, looks good.
Most definitely. You know, the way Wisejack's going, we're going to have cameras hanging everywhere.
Absolutely. I'll put a camera on your car.
Yeah.
So that all the viewers can...
Nobody's safe.
And this is Joshua Fist. Please check your bedroom. Stu's got a camera. Don't ask why, I don't know.
Well, I can think of a better bedroom to put a camera in. that's a nice one by Bill there. He's got another frame.
Yeah, I think it's 2-0, is it? Bill. So currently 2-1 for Bill.
That's a nice shot.
Yeah, that's got.
He's covered that red as well.
He's got a chance now, hasn't he? Yeah, that'll do. Just got to focus on the pot. Nothing else to do.
progressing nicely. Black in the tub, 1-0.
I've done just that. So, I see 1-0 to Dan. Bar a horrendous one. Which ain't
bad.
Well done, Dan.
I don't know where we're sleeping
too. That's the side view. Awful view from us tonight.
Terrible view. Well, I think the camera view is brilliant. The table looks a bit wonky.
Oh, it's the new smaller bulk tables.
Yeah. Right? It's dead narrow at one end and the other.
Have a look at the Bill Games, see what's going on over there. As you can see, Graham Lamb at the table. He's 2-1 down at the moment and he is on yellows.
That's the sort. They're the sort of breaks you want, where you've got a cue ball in the centre of the table. You've got a lovely choice. So which way would you be going here?
I'd be taking yellows. There's a pocket for them all. So take that middle one, drop down the front one below the red, and then work your way along the waist.
Yep.
That's how I go. Yeah. He's not just that.
Yeah, exactly that, exactly that. Yeah, nice. We'll be smooth sailing from here.
Yeah, don't forget to share our stream, guys. Really, really a few more views on this one, because this really is a good thing. Good match to watch.
So we've just got to swap these balls around, do we? Swap those around. Beautiful.
Play on the yellows. If I was a betting man, I'd say we won, but I'm not, so. Good job, I'm not a betting man.
Yeah, exactly. Just taking a last turn there. What's that? Did he?
Didn't he?
I think neither of us were watching.
Yeah, he did.
Should we ask the young man? Did he put the red there?
He did. No, yeah, he did.
Yeah, we did. We know he did. We're just playing with guys. Sandwich, total sandwich.
So if he's left out, he's fine, absolutely fine. Yeah. If that black goes to the bottom left,
pin.
Nice shot.
Dez does now, he's fast.
Yeah, we'll go. Yeah, just stun this, straight in.
Stun, you drop forward, yeah, all good.
Yeah, that's nice. And there we have it, one apiece.
A bit premature on the score there.
Let's have a, while he's racking up, let's have a quick flick over to see how Bill's getting on.
Bill is currently 3-1 in a race 2. Sorry,
unlucky by Bill.
He was going to be 3-1 up against Graham there in the plate final. Fresh off his win over Justin Eames.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But he's full of confidence there. He was in a bit of a snook, and I think he was trying to come off every single cushion.
The two legends in the background there.
I'll chuck him a wave. Should we give him a wave?
Hello.
Look at this. Beautiful.
Hello, Lee.
Hello.
Right, okay, so sorry, we was too busy waving at you that we didn't switch it over for the break, but you know, what's more important, really?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely.
You've got to think.
Lee Garrett, evening, Lee. Nice. Lee's always. I'm going to give Lee a gold subscription, I think, to Wise Joe.
I mean, what does the gold subscription include? Include a personal handshake from us. We ain't got much else to offer.
No, it's a webcam in the house.
Josh Fisk already a platinum subscriber.
Yeah, exactly.
Jack Hale's in the building.
Look at him. He looks like he's just had a shower.
Yeah. Don't forget to share our stream, guys. Let's get some exposure on this one, because this really is a cracker. Dan Yates potentially didn't make step number one at the moment, I would say. And Craig, who is, his name speaks for itself.
Exactly. But yeah. Then again, you know, you can always, you can put those two in the same group as Adam Wisby and Stuart Jackson, you know.
Well, let's quit the narcissism.
Yeah, yeah.
Leave the narcissism until next week.
Nah, two great players, two great players.
Let us know who you think is going to win. Actually, can we do a poll? Should we do a little poll?
Why don't we do it? Let's do a poll.
Let's do a poll, okay.
That's what we're there for.
Who's going to win? Who's going to pick your thoughts? Dan? Or Craig? So, poll incoming, guys. Start the poll. There you go.
Beautiful.
Bit of a leap there, Stu, yeah.
Have you noticed, as soon as we said that you can see us two in the actual camera, we've actually doubled the viewers.
Yeah. Yeah. Either that or I've just shared the link to loads of groups.
Yeah.
How's it going?
Yeah, it's alright.
Well, I'm going to watch some different rule sets while I play. Yeah, Lee Garrett, Blackpool player, aren't you, mate? This is international.
What's wrong with this? To move this pump. I can't read anything going.
Vote and close.
Well, I didn't vote. There.
No, we don't vote.
Nah.
We are non-partial to voting to people on our street. Dan in with the yellows here for a 2-1 lead.
I said, oh, Lee Garrett, thought I'd come and watch some different rule sets than I usually play. Well,
I've just literally done a whole speech.
Do you know what? old days. But then again, he can come and join the Tunbridge Premier League and play it week in, week out.
That's right, he can. Yeah, he's good.
That's another frame then. Well done.
Holding his own against a really good player.
Sean said frame betting is only open on two matches for another 10 minutes. Yeah, she's making the nails on.
You're now unmuted. There's only so much you can listen to in one go.
Let's know, guys, can you hear any music in the background? Just we'll have to turn it on if you can. So, the plate final, just a quick update, it's currently 4-1 to Bill. It was 4-1 up. It also erased 9 up in the lead. Craig, 33 in favour of Dan. What happened, Craig? So sorry just to interrupt this frame, I'm going to just bring you a tiny bit of match, Ben. You can message Sean Halligan on Facebook if you fancy any of these odds. As you can see, there's some really good artwork showcasing. Craig is on the red tip. Not your lasers are.
Little bit of a technical hitch there with the reds and yellows.
Technical hitch meaning lazy.
Do you know what? I was said that I was colourblind before.
Yeah. Tell you what, we haven't had.
You're not a doctor colourblind, you only see black and white. Hence the reason why we do not have any doctor commentating here.
Well, there goes our big surprise for the next match.
There was our next streaming event.
Yeah. But do you know what we haven't had? A cup of tea in a plastic cup.
Oh, don't. Slacking. Where is the Where is the hostess and the mostess?
Frame to grow. Which we missed because we were talking about bottles and cups of tea.
No, it's still going. It's still going on. Blackboard's
up
there.
Yeah, sorry. If you want to apply to become a commentator,
yeah. If want
to we're begging you to take the job.
Bit of a leap there, Stuart. Has he ever seen me jump? Old Chris. Like a kangaroo.
It's a bit top of this. Yeah, that's a good shot.
Just hold there.
If that middle one goes, I'd say Dan will go. Or any of those two, if any of those two go. Sure. Two bottom ones.
Should we have a flick of the view to see where we can have a look? Of that wonky table.
not the best angling for us today. We're always in a rush because
Stuart turned up late as usual.
Absolutely late. Oh.
Oh no.
Back to 50-50.
Yeah, it did drop. Yeah.
But he's still going to work that out.
Oh, yes. He hasn't come far enough forward to take it down and come back.
Sorry about you guys. The camera is terrible today. This is it.
Yeah, I've got, thanks to that, Chris, I've got twins. I'm currently supporting twins. They're due in about 3 months. Yeah, this is going to go tit for tat the whole way. Let's have a quick catch up on the Bills game. See how he's getting on.
Currently 4-1 to Bill against Graham Lamb. Bill at the table.
Nice little shot there by Bill. Yeah, he's full of confidence from his win at the weekend. I think he was caught in 2 miles between that shot.
He's still alright. I can't see. Let's go back to the damn game.
Just in time for the break, it's always nice.
Yeah.
For the production team to be on ball. A bit of a fly there, the cue ball. Oh, excellent! I don't have to change it. It's always nice, isn't it? When you're on the production team, and you don't have to do sod all. Oh no. I need a bigger chair. I feel like I'm sitting on a bottle top. Not that I've sat on bottle tops that often. I'm just saying it's a bit of a small chair. Circumference this is.
Always get stuff on the stool. I like the idea though. He's left that. Grid on the left side.
Yeah,
it's just one of those where you can cross back double it, but you've got to be really high on it to do so.
It's 4-2 now to Bill.
4-2 to Bill, Graham Lamb pulling one back.
Yeah, excellent. Yeah, it's just got that one ball by the yellow there on the left cushion. Or is he just going to leave that for a cross double later?
This is what I was saying, the cross double, like, from that position it's not that easy because you've got to be high on it. Like really high, I think.
Yeah.
You could leave this angle low. Yeah, so the one to the left middle low, and then crash into them. Bit of lady luck on this side.
Lock a bit of lady luck. Yeah. It's on for it now. He's going to develop the other one at the same time.
That's good. That's a good shot.
I think that red does go in the middle.
Shot on the left.
Yeah.
No, that's all. That's frozen.
You reckon it's frozen?
Well, it's close to being frozen. It isn't. That's not a. That's me. No way. It's not going in the middle.
But I think he's going to develop it now.
Yeah. That's a decent shot.
Yeah.
I think
he can drop that in, and then he's got a nice angle to come off this one. Now
you say it, that might go to me,
don't I think he might. I mean, I used to be a sniper in the Royal Marines. My eyesight's long distance eyesight.
Is that a bar in a work title?
I'm sorry, I'm still talking about
a bar for Royal Marines.
Yeah. I think I'm still talking about my son's Xbox game. Yeah, I reckon he put some top left on this. Oh no, he didn't want it. He must go, he must just drop in then. Yeah, excuse that, guys, he's got a bit of a sneezing bout here. So
did go.
Yeah, it did go.
My eye,
I'll tell you, it was Sniper Stew, as you call me. That's it, let's just drop this one in, and it's 3-2 to Craig.
And that's 3-2 to Craig.
Right, and it's a big shout out from the crowd there. So let's nip over and see how Bill and Graham's getting on. Look at that beautiful commentating team in the corner. I think I have to change the angle of the camera. We don't really want to see us, do we?
Can you use that Zoom facility?
Oh, we can do. What's zooming to us?
We've been back to this check me out sort of thing.
I mean, it's but, a nice close view, it's nice.
Still 4-2 to Bill in the plate. Race to 9. Lammy on yellows. Yeah. And again, straight under the break.
Yeah, they're. I don't think they separated that greatly that time.
He's got to go for a walk because his legs are going dead. So done up for the break for the sick front. So what's going on here? Craig ball in hand. Yellow off the red. And then all the yellows have a bag. That's the shot. White off. Oh, no, he's taken reds. I probably would have gone yellows there, if I'm honest. So still 4-2 to Bill in the plate. Long rack going on. Got a little supporter today, yeah. Craig, is Craig going to win? Or is Dan going to win? He's nodded. And what is your name? Harley. Big shout out to Harley, helping us on the commentary. Well, around the studio.
Yeah, doing a better job with Stuart.
Absolutely, yeah. Stuart's actually not on his seat now. Harley's taking it, so. Has Craig gone red? I mean, it's all right, I suppose. I probably would have gone yellows. Just an update on the match betting. 9-8 for either Bill or Graham to win. For Graham or Bill to win 9-8. It's now 5-1. So message Sean if you like a bet. I don't know too much about betting, so apologies if I'm coming across really bad. Message Sean, and he'll let you know. Dan on a chance in the yellows here to even up the scores. They all have a pocket, he's just got to work his way around them. Are we back, Lee? Because we did mute for a little bit there.
Well, I just want to do a quick shout out to my grandson Charlie, who's up watching again. He's an avid pool player. He's only 10 years old, and he's here watching me at home, or not watching me, watching the guys play pool, listening to me commentating. So, Charlie, this is a big shout out to you. Also, I know you've got your sisters there, Alice and Sienna. It's about time these girls were in bed. So, yep. Anyway, well done, Charlie. Big shout out to the grandkids.
Hi Ash, so currently the score is 4-2 in Bill's favour. I'll put that in the messages as well. 4-2. Just a reminder there, for Bill or Graham to win 9-8, the odds are now at 5-1, and you just have to message Sean Halligan on Facebook if you fancy a little wager. And I think, do you know what? It's now 4-3 to Bill, so it's tit for tat all the way, and that could be a good bet. I don't know much about betting, but if you're a betting man, go for it. Or a woman, betting woman. Hi Lee, yeah, once we're big time, we will invest into bear headsets, but at the moment, we're sharing a decibel between us. Stu, coming back on commentary?
Yep, coming back. Cheers mate, thank you. I might swap chairs in as well. Are there removal things going on? I've got my little leg support in front for me as well. Did we? Ugh. I think it was falling off the back there. That's your charger again. That's okay, I think it goes into this one here. Is everyone hanging down? That's it. If I do, it's done. Done when you plan for electricity. Excellent, thank you. Alright, Stu's back on the comms. Yeah, and that's another frame to Dan. So we're back to three apiece. Riveting stuff for the commentating team here.
Slow as well.
What, the pool play or the commentating? Well, Dan's on yellows again, so I don't have to change my little covered balls about, which is nice.
You know, if Dan decides to stick with yellows, then that's a good thing, because you don't have half as much work to do.
So the
Yeah, thanks for that, Lee. I've ditched my headset from the weekend. That was atrocious, and I'm just using the mic from the webcam in the actual studio production area. So hopefully it should sound a bit better. Shot there by Dan.
Can you ask him if that's two single £10 bets? And if it is, yes.
Oh, perfect, thank you very much. So, hostess isn't mostess, let's just pour our coffees out, keep us going for the evening.
Yes, indeed. Yeah, got coffee in a mug, and the cups have been double mugged today, so it means we don't burn our hand as much.
Nothing like a double mugging. Well, I've never had a mugging, to be honest with you.
What's that balaclava of your coffee?
Yeah. That's when I put them webcams up.
Ash Walker, ref of the weekend for the money matches, has tuned in. And again, Ash, just want to say thank you very much for your time and effort and your professionalism throughout the day. He was awesome, wasn't he?
Well, he was. He didn't really move much, did he? I thought he was asleep half the time.
Do you know what? He is that attractive that our AI picked him up without us asking it to.
Oh, no. He was absolutely sure that he was. Thanks. He wants an update from the Rays and Army match, so it's currently 4-3 to Bill. And then mid-frame.
Yeah, it's 4-3 to Bill Rays in the plate final. Craig on reds.
Oh, we've got a loss of light.
A loss of
We've had a power cut.
Dan, can you get light 5, please? Sorry there, guys. The light has just gone up. It will be back on very shortly.
That was nothing to do with the production team.
For once, we are not.
Yeah, for once, it wasn't us.
Been sort of tit for tat so far.
I know.
Craig on the black here for a 4-3. And that is lovely.
Very nice.
That is a lovely black. Well done, Craig.
Let's have a quick nip over to Bill's game.
Four to the table.
Let's have a look at, should we have a look at this Paris queue, see what it works like?
Yeah, someone had to look at a Craig 8 queue.
Mate, look at that.
My queue is not for sale.
Yeah, it's for hire.
Yeah, it's for hire.
20 quid a bottle.
Hi Jan, what's going on, Stu? We've got some buffering going on.
Well, not too sure, to be honest with you.
Encouraging words here from our tech guy. Let's have a look at
just flick it at the top there. So just flick the switch. Sure, actually. I mean, it was shown just a second ago. It was excellent quality.
Still 4-3 to Bill. He's currently on the black to the middle. So this is 5-3 to Bill.
Let me log out of the Wi-Fi.
And he's nailed it. So that's 5-3 to Bill Wales.
Alright, so I'm gonna come off the Wi-Fi. And
Stu just trying to do Stu things to get the stream. No buffering.
Yeah, I'll just give myself that. I think it's ever since Jan Spinner just said that Bill's wearing dirty trousers.
Oh, God. So just watching the stream itself, guys, just to check any buffering. So it's looking right. I don't see the buffering at the moment. Mm.
Craig on the yellow.
Jan says you went to work this morning with clean trousers on, now they're looking dirty.
He's all been pulled up on his trousers there.
Yeah.
Phil was just told me that is the sign of a hard-working man.
A hard-working man.
That's a positive way to spin a negative situation.
We got some wisejack attire. I think we've got some leotards we can lend him.
You better take yours off first.
Yeah.
Lend him yours, what are you wearing right now?
Some bright green ones. Do either call me the elf or Robin Hood, I'm not too sure which one.
Robin Elf.
Yeah. I'll have to get that back on my shirt.
I don't fancy this coffee now.
What if I say stronger?
Yeah. There's more buffering going on. I'm really sorry, guys. I'm not sure what's going on here with the buffering and why it's doing it. I guess asking for perfection from the stream all the time is difficult.
Well, we
don't deliver it any time.
No, exactly. the most annoying thing is, it's not the actual setup. It's always down to the Wi-Fi. It's always down to the Wi-Fi, which is really annoying.
Jan's been here at the weekend. She was supporting Bill in his race with. It was a good match, that, I thought.
Yeah, it was good. Very good match. It was, I think it got very close up to the midway point, and then.
Yeah, tit for tat in the single figures.
Yeah.
And then Bill pulled away four racks, and was it really?
Yeah, I think Justin did try and work his way back, and.
Anyone at any time can go down four racks in a race.
Yeah.
That's the difficult part of the race, so. So back to the action. Dan is on the reds, as Stuart Dunn, again, looking fantastic with the ball colours. Hint.
Oh, is there a... There's nothing wrong with those. Look at those. Look.
Oh, sorry, it must be my... Must be those sniper eyes of yours. You can see.
Do you know the best thing to do? It's just to keep the viewers on their toes. Keep guessing. Yeah. You know, and I'll just change colours on the penultimate ball.
So Craig putting the yellow in the bag there. Just give me a sip of this one. So far. Dan putting the black over the bag there. I don't know why. This is coffee.
Yeah.
Hallucinating.
I don't know. Not too sure what Adam's watching.
So the poll is currently 71% down, even though Craig's 4-3 up.
So don't forget to share the stream, guys. We're doing this all for you. You know, we do have a day job as well, and we come out in the evenings, and we travel half the way across the country to give you Wise Jack Productions. Wise Jack Buffering, we're gonna change the name to.
I watched Kingpin last night, if anyone remembers that film. It's about a bowler.
Before the
air, an old bowler who lost his hand, so he finds another good bowler, and then they go and hustle everyone. I feel that's kind of like what we do, and that is our day job. We don't actually hustle, just for the information. Harley is in the studio. That's Craig's stepson.
What are we doing? I can see him there. He seems to be popping around.
I can see he's actually a Manchester United fan, and. I think we might have to ban him from the studio. Who's your favourite player, Harley? Marcus Rashford.
Good old Rashford. Meals for the school kids.
Good old Rashford.
Do you reckon he's in the Euro 24 squad?
I don't know if he's going to make it in that squad. I think they've got more stronger forwards to pick, but you know, Southgate, he goes reliable, doesn't he?
Exactly. I'm sure your phone hasn't rang yet.
I They asked me, but I said I was washing my hair.
You're streaming.
Yeah, got more important things to do.
Streaking or streaming?
Like the ultimate pairs in Tunbridge. Craig will not try to at yellows to take a two rack lead.
Yeah.
In a race to nine, you know, two racks aren't going to ain't much. It doesn't mean much.
That's it, just tap and stun, I say so.
Tap and stun, yeah. Is it just tap it in? Happy Gilmore style, just tap it in. Tap it in. Just tap, tap, tap a room. Craig for this black for 5-3.
And there she goes.
There we have it. So, at the moment, both the main and the semi, sorry, the main and the plate, is 5-3. 5-3 to Bill, Ray's, and 5-3. It's a great one.
How coincidental is that? We just couldn't have called that.
No, you couldn't have.
Dan's going to be breaking soon. We will switch back over for the live action for the break.
Just to let you know, anyone who's watching, we do have another big money match day coming up on the 4th of May. If you do want a match, we do have one slot left in the morning to go on stream. If it's something you'd like to do or have always wanted to do, get in touch. We might be able to pair you up with someone, or you might have a match of your own. So let us know.
Yeah, most definitely. These are getting really popular. And yeah. You know, even if you don't want to go on the mainstream, then come along and be an undercard. You know, we've got tables available for the day.
Sorry, boss, we're just
about
black. Oh, no. We're not here.
No, we're streaming. We're streaming live. I'm just showing you black
so,
screens.
So, looking at the scorecard at the moment, Bill is Craig Mallander, and Lanny is.
Yeah.
Because it is 5-3.
That's a nice shot there, Bob Bill.
Do you know what? Graham Lamb, I believe, is top of the MDPL division singles. So he's won most racks in the league this season.
Is it really?
He's not the rematch, but he's a top
rack,
Graham.
No, it's
not. Yeah, nice store.
Yeah. No, I'm fine, thanks.
We are just on a quick interval break on the Dan versus Craig game, so we bring in live action from Bill and Graham. Yeah. We'll be shortly going back over. Yeah, so we will be doing some production work for the Big Money Mayhem Day on the 4th of May, if you fancy it. Keep your
It'll
eye
out. It'll be advertised soon, yeah, and we are still looking for one more match. If you want to come on the stream, there is a bit of a better setup than what we're showing at the moment for the day. If you watched on Saturday, you would have seen it.
On the main arena? The main arena setup?
The main arena, that's it.
That was a beautiful setup, that was.
Yeah, it was. I'm glad I thought of it.
Oh, you did. I'll tell you, the only other thing we need to think of is getting a trolley jack to move them pool tables around. I'm not as young as I was.
You bench press them in your sleep. So back underway, down on the reds.
Excellent, don't have to change your colours.
Is he on his bottom line?
I can't get there. Should we have a look at the wonky table? Nothing really gets you a view, does it? Yeah,
he's on that.
Well, we're not going to show too much of that view tonight. It's to do with the camera slit.
Yeah.
And we don't want to be messing around with it.
We're running a bit late, so we didn't have time to angle it up properly, so our apologies.
I think it was angled, but by the time we got over to the studio and sat down, it was slit. Do you know what it was? It's that cameraman aiming from the ceiling. He's moved. You know, I'll tell you what we need Ash, he don't move. He can aim from the ceiling and hold that camera dead still.
If he didn't move. If he did ever move, the AI would pick it up anyway. So.
I know.
I hope the buffering sorted itself out, guys. Craig with another chance on the other side. Which are, you know, decent chance here for a free get free right lead.
Which one of the pack of crisps there? What's your flavour?
lightly sea salted. Very nice. Very nice indeed. What's your favourite crisp there?
My favourite crisp.
Or flavour?
Do you know what? Recently I've been partial to Quavers barbecue.
Quavers barbecue?
Nice. So if I ever go back late from playing pool, I always pick one up in like the petrol station that's open. I do like a meal deal and they're always a crisp and meal.
Oh.
What's your flavour?
Do you know what? There's so many. There's so many.
I feel like you're a bit of a pickled onion monster munch.
Do you know what? I do love a bit of a pickled onion monster munch. I don't know if it's the purple packet that draws me to it.
You look like the monster on the front.
Well, the X does.
If you're tuned in, Stuart X, have that.
I do like the old Thai sweet chili, the old green pack, the original pack.
I'm not really a crisp one.
No. Skips. I like skips a melt in the mouth.
I'm really crispy. If I eat crisps, it's only ever because I've got to get the pack due to a meal deal. I don't ever buy them on their own. I tend to buy some fridge raiders.
Oh yeah. Chicken fridge raiders. Turkey Twizzlers.
See, they have put them back, but they're not the same.
That's an Iceland special, turkey Twizzlers for Christmas.
Imagine you go to your family's for a nice Christmas dinner. All the veg and the potatoes come out, and out comes a plate of turkey Twizzlers. And do you know what? I'd be happy with that.
Most definitely.
I'd be happier than turkey, because turkey... Why are we talking about Christmas? Let's get back on the game.
Turkey's so dry though, isn't it?
Just like I can't sense of humour.
I mean, you can add a bit of cranberry sauce. I wonder if you can add cranberry sauce to turkey Twizzlers. Anyway, back to the action. Lovely shot there by Dan.
Lovely shot from the red. He's got a chance here to take these out. Would you be going plant or right back?
I'll be going right back with some spin.
Yeah.
I just don't like where the white will be after that plant.
You draw back like 5 inches.
He's definitely taking the right choice there. If he has.
No, he's not. No, he's fine on that bottom one. You can just draw back out for the red, I think.
Bill just got another frame. It's currently 6-3 to Bill over Graham.
6-3 to Bill, raise at the moment against Graham. So 3 from the win.
No, so he is covered. Yeah. Oh, that is a great shot.
What no problem for them, yeah, of course. What a shot.
What a great shot. So he's definitely taken away out route harder, though.
Yeah.
Oh, he's left a bit straight on there, but that's a nice
play. Yeah, he's right. Let's have a look.
And there she drops.
Yeah, nailed it.
Beautiful.
So that is 5-4.
Yep.
It's as close as you're going to get it for a while. Current poll is sitting at 56% for Dan to win this final. Let's get Craig Mullen up. Is Craig Mullen the current champ?
Not too sure. Let's have a quick look at Bill's break. Or he's having a look. We might not have time for Bill's break because he's having a chat.
Right, let's have a look here. There you go, Bill. So Bill 6-3 up.
Alright, and we're just going to switch over. Oh, sorry.
The white bounce, but.
We just jumped back over in time for Craig's break using that lovely John Paris cue. Hope he's jumping
in. He's a new tip anyway, yeah.
Yeah. He has got some power, that boy, isn't he? Do you reckon it's his height? Or the length of the arms?
I just think he's an all rounded player. He knows the game inside out. Mm. He's played with the best.
Yeah, I've seen
he's
him.
He's beaten the best.
I've seen him. I wouldn't say on TV, on a few of these YouTube
say the
things.
Best. He's beaten the top players.
Very nice, yeah. Where's your coffee? Do
it worth waiting for?
I didn't burn my hand on my coffee today.
Oh.
That's good little lad, isn't it? Oh, crazy. Stepson. Clearing up.
Helping out. Clearing up some coffee cups on Charlie. Thank you, mate.
He keeps on looking.
Oh,
no, no.
Come on, Greg.
No, I think he's going to play. He's going to do conservative. Let's do a poll. Conservative or attacking?
Attacking. He's going attacking. There's a chance here for Dan if he can nail this plant down the left side.
Yeah.
just missed that.
So I think he might.
I think he's covered that middle.
No, he hasn't covered that top yellow. He can work his way around these.
Yeah, no, I was
top left.
The sniper wasn't looking that far at the table. My eyes only got to mid drift.
So all that coffee.
Yeah.
All that plastic coffee.
Oh, damn.
Hopefully for next Monday day we will invest in some really decent headsets and some commentary lessons.
Sean had a good commentary lessons, same as his coaching. Both in one day.
Just want to say again, thanks to Cole Jones for commentating most of the day on Saturday.
Yeah, no, that was great of him, and it's he doesn't know it yet, but we've signed him up for the next one.
Yeah, Carl, if you're listening, mate, you're officially contracted to work for us. Stand back at the table. Still an opportunity, I mean. I'd like to see him take these out. I do love a match that's tied. Creates more drama, better viewing.
That's it.
I don't want to pick a winner out of both of these. So I think they're both great players. Both decent players.
If I went for that shot there, my belly would be rolling them three balls around the table. I haven't got the athleticism I had when I was in my 20s.
You still got a little bit though,
haven't you? Oh, very much so, very much
so.
How'd
the triathlon go out the weekend?
Yeah, I come second.
Who won it?
Oh, I don't want to say. Jabba the Hutt.
That's a good shot from Dan. Because now you can play this midget one. With a touch of freedom, actually. You can almost cut this red in. It's probably thinner. It probably looks thinner on our screens. Let's go this one. That'll do you. It's covered. Yeah, it's a good shot. Just lost a turn here from Craig, most likely. Yeah. He's gone skilly and it hasn't worked out. I'm not going to win.
Nearly sunk that one. These should be Dan should be clearing these up there, shouldn't he?
He's putting so much right, it's just to swing that right hand. And that's why, because now he's See, this is a pressure shot now, because if he misses, look at them yellows.
Most definitely. Which pocket would you be going for this red?
If it might go top right.
Yeah. That would be the natural, wouldn't it?
And then a stun off the left cushion, back over. Or you can risk it all the top right. No, top left, sorry. Lifted a difficult black. This is why I would have stunned. But very often do these that Dan can do.
They're both same game.
Have you got Tony's number?
No.
Yeah, this is. So I wasn't paying attention, mate.
I'm assuming we actually just got disrupted there, I think. That may have that flag. Just going to confirm that.
Yeah, Dan. And there we go.
Glad production's paying attention.
Janet's got the triathlon or trifle one.
Yeah, it was a. Oh, thanks for that. I spilt it all down Bill's trousers.
I'm just going to say it now, Stu. Like, I know, for the weight and stuff, you eat very healthy. Healthier than me. Yeah, butternut squash soup the other day. I mean, I've never had
that. Fair enough.
Are you a bit of a chef?
Well, I do like to cook in the kitchen.
Yeah, I wish I could cook.
Right, are we going to switch these over now?
So it's now 6-4 to Hill, and Graham's pulled back. Craig on the red tape. All got pocket.
Yeah, we got Craig on the right colours for a change.
He hasn't played that well. Because he's got to use this yellow, he's got to hit this yellow, and he's too thin. He's too thin, he has to go running out of it.
Shot there.
Did he hurt your head?
Yeah,
held it. I didn't think he could, I thought it was too thin. Good
no, shot. Yeah, no, he full ball the yellow.
He's doubled it. Is he going to do another double? Is this double double?
Double double, yeah, double trouble. Or was he going to middle left and cut that in?
I don't know, is it a cut? I think it's very thin. Very thin.
It's got
a great shot, nailed that. Not the easiest of blacks, but confidence off them two pots, we should get it. And he has.
Yeah,
that's 6-5.
6-5,
tip
so.
Bringing us the best possible outcome of this match.
Jump over to Bill's game.
Bill is a 6-4 up at the moment, he's currently at the table. He's in the Brits. Half a chance.
Oh.
Just gone for the continued safety and the bad covenant. And that touch short, but still absolute. No problem there. Back at the table on the yellows.
Right, we should be just going to jump back over to the main game.
Main game.
We'll keep bringing you over to the plate final in the intervals. Right, looks like Dan's going to be on reds.
Yeah. He is. And Ale. Yeah, that's a good shot. If he busts this bottom one out now, favourably, then they all have a pocket.
Mm-hmm.
But
got a question from the crowd.
What's that, Harley? What Harley was saying there is on my screen is showing this file, but that's the live stream. There is a delay in the live stream compared to what's happening right this second. Yes. Spotted a 5-0, but it's actually 6-5.
Our technical guru pointed that out to us over there. Thank you very much.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, basically what it is, obviously we're live streaming, and it takes a little bit of time for the computer software to decode the video footage into a format which is readable with the program. So that's why you'd always get a slight delay. You know, sometimes it's 30 seconds, sometimes it's a minute. But if you're looking on the, if you're watching on YouTube, then obviously it's a bit behind the actual live play.
I concur with whatever he just said.
Thank you.
My technical knowledge is as useful as an inflatable dartboard, so thank you for that.
Just looking through these. Oh, he's just rattled the jaws out. Do you think he was trying to nip it off that red?
Yep. Tell us, guys, is there anything you'd like to see from us? Is there any events or something you think you would, say on a Saturday, you wanted to tune into Paul, is there any kind of event you'd like to watch? Or do you like doubles? Do you like what sort of comps? Do you like fun days? Like shootouts? I don't know.
Yeah, no, exactly.
You know, any ideas, let us know, because we do run our own events.
Yeah, if there's a special event you want to see, let us know. We are a production, so we will do the full production, we'll organise it, run the events, and do the live streaming.
Obviously, we'd have to think about it, you know, so our time is precious.
Exactly. Yeah, well, we've got the big Money Mayhem match coming up, so if you fancy getting yourself involved in that, or fancy playing someone for money, let us know. We've got a slot available in the main arena. Yeah.
We have two matches already planned, but we'll keep them under wraps for now.
Yep, most definitely.
I think the last one was quite successful.
Very much, very, very successful.
Bar a couple of technical errors, but we've smoothed them over now.
It was annoying, really, because we should have done that prep before, but we tried out a new Wi-Fi, and
it didn't really work, did it?
The cameras had a hissy fit, and anyway, not going into that. So it delayed us a tiny bit, but we got there in the end. It's a very good day. I mean, it was just unfortunate that one of the games in the evening we couldn't live stream straight away because the game during the midday obviously started a bit later than we anticipated. So it overrang its due course, and the guys wanted to start early on another table. So it's their prerogative. So unfortunately, we couldn't stream that one for you. But
we're not ones to not rectify our errors, and can assure you those two guys will get back on the stream.
Most definitely.
Dan Bowles and Matt Meeks both absolutely prioritise their money for any money match. Craig on Yellow Zero, thank you. This is turning into a bit of a world
prize. Yeah, and there's another frame for Bill there, so Bill is currently 7-4 up.
7-4 up, 2 to go. For Bill, 5 to go for Graham Lamb.
Yeah, we thought you'd give you some ambience though, so we've got some Usher playing in the background.
Really
yeah, well, you know, for not us playing it, but
we don't mean the rights to this song, just to let you know.
Yeah, or any music you can hear in the background. Nothing to do with Wise Jack Productions.
Unless you start singing Ave Maria like you do on most occasions.
Yeah.
That was your cue to start singing shit, but never mind.
What's that?
Maybe next week.
Well, I might get up and have a little jiggle. Well, not jiggle, a little. Nah, I don't want to start that up again. I'll be getting some comments in there, won't I?
Yeah.
Yeah. Or have a little dance.
Have a little dance. Dan back at the table on yellows. No, on red. Sorry.
Yeah, Bill's just had a nice break. He Got one or two down there off the break.
We've got a snooker on at the club as well. Ali Carter's playing Barry Hawkins. Ali Carter, 9-6 up in the race to 10. But Barry on the pink, he's already won this rack frame, he's already won this one. So it's now 9-7.
Ali, good lad, thank you very much.
See, we're even commenting on the professionals now.
I know. Do you know what I think will suit Bill? Some braces. Well, not mouth braces, but obviously.
If you put braces on Bill, he'd look like one of the little men on top of a German clock.
You have to get him some Lederhosen, are they called?
Lederhosen.
Lederhosen. Get him fanny in some of those.
Yeah.
I was thinking more Bobby Ball.
I know the name. I'm not going to lie to you, I don't. No idea. Craig on a long yellow here.
No, he's missed it.
Skewed it a little bit. Dan Yates, Arsenal fan.
Is he?
Who do you support, Stuart?
Well, I actually support the team from where I was born, which is Charlton Athletic. So as I was born.
Up into the valley.
Yeah.
Not doing great this season.
Well, they used to do very well. And then we seem to drop down two or three leagues within a couple of seasons.
I remember you in the Prem with Klaus Jensen. Was it Darryl Powell or Darren Powell?
Yep. Clive Mendonca, who was up there?
Yeah, Clive Mendonca. No, that's Middlesbrough.
Yeah, we had Adam Kerbishley as our manager.
Is he still manager?
Andy Bowyer in midfield, I think he was. Is he still manager? I'm not too sure. To be honest with you, I'm one of these. I mean, I used to go to the Valley quite a lot when I was in my early 20s and that, but I don't do anything nowadays.
Well, play for them. On the odd occasion when they need a miracle win.
That was a nice double there by Dan.
Yeah. He's on the Reds. I mean, this is no easy feat from here, but. If that red passes that yellow down the bottom left and he holds for the gap, he has to go over there and shake his hand, I think.
Yeah, that'd be a great shot.
Yeah, I don't know if he slides.
I think he's eyeing it up. Yeah, he's definitely eyeing it up.
There's no way back.
He must. Yeah.
Oh, he's eyeing it up, though. Yeah, that's all right. 7-4 through Bill against Grantland. Bill at the table on reds. He's got three reds and a black. If he nails this, I feel like that'd be 8-4.
Headphones and a mic.
Remember, guys, Tuesday nights, if you're feeling hungry, get yourself on a.
Is it Uber Eats?
Deliver and Just Eat. Get yourself on there and order some food from Century.
Yeah. Food's banging.
Brilliant food.
I'm going to say this every week because someone buys.
Yeah, they do some great food. Don't they do discounts on Tuesday?
I don't actually know, not that I
go on these food apps because I usually healthily cooking in the kitchen or living off turkey twizzlers. but yeah,
good pals with Jamie Oliver. Craig's made a bit of a mess of that, not the saddest of outcomes, but what I'd be playing here is red or fresh.
Yeah.
As slow as possible, because what that will do is push the bottom red over the left bag and pop the right one. And
that would be a cracking shot.
It would be a cracking shot, but you do risk leaving a double for Craig.
Yeah.
That's the shot I was talking about. But he's all right. He's all right.
Yeah, no.
If you played it softer, that may have held. But that's exactly the shot.
Yeah.
Played it really well.
Yeah. Even they can
chip this in middle.
Yeah. Bring around two cushions back in the bottom.
Medium pace. There you go. And that's it. And it's black for six all. And do you know what? I've just got to take my hats off to Dan because Craig is no easy match and he's going tip for tap.
And there she goes, 6-6. Right, let's bring Poppy back over onto Bill's game.
So, what I'm trying to say is when Craig pulls away, he pulls away.
Yeah.
Dan hasn't allowed it to. Yeah, a bit of a well balls match here between Bill on the Reds. Currently 6-4 up.
Well, while Bill's thinking there, we'll go back and watch Dan on the break. Yeah, there's a crunching break as well.
Crunching break, but it's gone dry, hasn't it? That's, I think they're a bit sickening because you have all those balls moving at such pace. You think the problem is the amount just dropping in.
It is.
Just frustrating.
Do you know what I think the problem is? The wonky table.
the wonky table.
All jokes aside.
Let's make the wonky table viral.
Yeah, that's it.
Grandman with the big hand in the yellows. 7-4. But that match is not over by a long shot.
No, definitely.
The poll is currently 62% for Dan to win this match.
I don't think the little man here agrees with that.
Right, got Harley in the studio who is Craig's stepson to be.
Yeah.
He's a Manchester United fan and his favourite player is Marcus Rashford. Is Marcus Rashford making the Euros? Let us know. The big debate here. I don't think he will, unless Southgate sticks with reliability.
Or just names.
Yeah,
well, he sticks with names.
I saw Jermaine Defoe around the other day, so...
Did you see him at Jermaine Defoe?
Yeah. Like he's warming up.
Yeah. Jermaine Defoe and Peter Crouch.
Yeah. Bringing back the old school.
He's not that red into that yellow now.
Might go twice across here and try and play that red in there to the left centre. No, he's still
yeah.
off the yellow. He's just played safe.
Yeah, he's just covered up the foot.
There's suddenly he's going to start playing well.
So a bit of a tactical one between Bill and Graham, the plate final. I can't really sit there.
Bill's giving away four down three shots in a row.
Sometimes it's just not worth anything because the balls are so clumped.
Just like a loss of turn, really, isn't it?
Yeah. Good shot. Great shot from down there. Every chance of taking this down. He's put himself in the lead. We're going double or chip.
I think he's going to just cut it in the middle, yeah. Bring it around.
Using golf terms now for football.
Exactly.
Chip in the middle.
Chip in the middle.
You know, driver on the break.
Do you reckon he's going to slice this one?
If he puts his yellow, that will be a hole in one.
Oh, he's just dropped that one in nicely.
He's perfect. Wow.
Bit of top on this.
Bit of top.
Yellow bottom.
Always
black got to
do is focus on the bottom.
Yeah, we've got that one.
Good shot down.
Oh, that's it. Just this one there. Just stun this one.
62% is still in that big trade.
Yeah, he's on the black nicely.
Yeah, nailed it.
There we
go. Nailed it. 7-6.
Yeah. Right, back over to Bill to see how he's getting on.
Yeah, opened up a little bit.
Currently 7-4, and that's
Bill is reds, Graham at the table on yellows at the moment. And he is 7-4 down to Bill.
Right, should we nip back over and see your John Paris queue in action?
Let's do it. Craig Mallard are using my queue.
I think we just got a little interval break now. I think the ref's gone for number one. For technical terms.
Let's start a poll, number one or number two.
Yeah. What has the ref gone for? I need a hand dry going. Must be a number one.
Yeah.
We'll see whether he comes out like a stone lighter. Here he comes.
We're going to stay.
He's running. There must be number two.
No, busy
back. Jumping upstairs a bit high.
You'll see me jumping up those stairs.
Let's see if Graham. He's cut this in. Is he on this yellow? Oh, he's half and half.
Right, we're just going to nip back over to the break now.
I'll let you know if Graham wants that.
Yeah, I think your break cue's working. What? Sorry, that's impossible. Oh. I might try out some of Aussie's cuisine this evening. Yeah. All these commentators making me a bit.
Yeah, Graham's nailed that yellow and
yeah. He should be on this black now to bring back the five.
There we go. Let's have a look. Yeah, he's nailed it. So that's 7-5 to Bill. Graham pulling one back there. Back to the Craig game. The Craig and Dan game, as I call it. I'm keeping the Craig game.
Yeah, should we know what colours they're on? I'd say that Craig's on reds.
Yeah.
See, I'm on the ball already.
He's on the ball.
Yeah.
He didn't have to move that.
Man, I had a 50-50 guess.
Craig's position's been up to his usual standards. When you pop like that, it really doesn't matter, does it?
No.
Oh my god.
That's a lovely shot.
Yeah.
It's looking determined here, Craig.
MDL singles final, race to place to two, technically, if pop.
Well, I'll see what you've done there.
Good shot.
Mathematical genius.
I did apply for countdown. Well,
there you have it.
There we are.
7-0, going all the way.
There's Bill in his dirty work trousers, as Jan said.
7-5. Bill's up. 2 frames to the plate. There's not who you think is going to win. In the live chat. I've noticed that our live chats are not saving when the streams are being published. So.
Oh right, okay.
I have to get our technical Einstein on it.
Oh, you've got his number? Yes. No. Well, to be honest with you,
I've had a lot of comments saying our chats haven't saved. If people do like to.
Yeah, I'd have to have a look into that because when we go back on, obviously we own the account, so when we go back on, they're there, we can read them.
Maybe a shame.
Yeah, but. Yep, something I'll have a look at anyway, guys.
So, Dan is on the red box. Is Dan on the red box? Because I'm not on the ball.
Do you know what? I'm going to preempt you and say he's going to take reds.
He's already on the reds anyway.
Yeah, anyway. We knew that.
He's alright, he's fine here. I think a delicate little shot for that red around where the break spot is for the middle bag, and these could go. A little typo in our stream. We have updated it. We've put Craig down as Craig Malinda.
Do you know what? I did take a typing lesson when I was younger at school. it was shorthand, and I couldn't understand what he was mouthing to me earlier.
You learn how to write doctors, right?
Oh yeah, you can never understand those.
No.
Yeah, sorry about that. It was my old quick fingers there.
Oh damn, not lucky. He needs to find a shot to get on this red on the top half of the table. He may just dump this on the bottom bag, on the bottom rail now for the red. Not unless he's going for this double. He might double. Top right.
I think he's in the double top right.
He's missed it, but he's dumped it anyway. Yeah, it's turned out nice.
Are we going to have a custom after show game?
I'll just leave the salad then. I'll just. No salad. A
little waste of three.
Follow me.
Yeah, great pot for Craig. He's got to pull out another one now, though. When your back's against the wall, that is a cracking pot.
Oh, it's just a knuckled that one.
Knuckled it. So, one good positional shot here. Play the left, the bottom left, roll it down, head into the bottom right, black tangle. It's just gone a bit short. You might be able to just float between the red and the yellow here. For red into the bottom left. See what happens.
Yeah, we throw a nice shot.
Yeah, that's the shot. Bit thin.
What's he going to do? Is he going to play into the black?
Again, I think he can float this between the closest yellow and the black. Just with a touch, just the bottom, just to straighten the white out. And then play the black in the bottom left. That's what I'm seeing. Oh, he could go gung-ho and come in. Still 7-5, Bill versus Graham. Don't take it this time of the shot, rightly so. It's a big shot to give a bit of context in the match, isn't it?
Yeah, I think he's going to try and bring that between the yellow and the black.
Yeah. Yeah, he's gone gung-ho.
Oh.
But do you know what? That's
turned
out.
That's not too bad,
that's
actually.
Turned out fine.
Duffy's got a natural pot here, isn't he?
No, but I think that'll be sweet. He's got nothing to go at.
Is he going to go cross double, is he, or is he just going to leave it safe?
Yeah, it's just. Oh, has he split them? That's fine. Yeah, that's not easy to get off. You can play the up and down, but the margins, getting that right, a bit difficult to gauge, you know? So if you go off the top rail down to the red there, you can slide, you know, you've got to be really accurate. What would you be doing?
Pretty good, Sean Hannigan, sit on the table and swerve it 180 degrees.
Everything in this club is referred to as a Sean Hannigan.
The Sean Hannigan swerve.
We need to find a new sponsor of prop name.
What are we doing here?
He's going up and down, I think.
Yeah.
But if he gets it, I mean, these are hard to judge. These are very hard to judge. With them, yeah, you can hit the yellows. I see, yeah, slid off. Forehand to Craig.
Goodness, has that been the first ball in hand we've seen in this match?
No, I've seen a couple.
Have you really?
Yeah.
I don't know what I've been looking at.
I think you've been watching the snooker, mate.
I've been commentating on the wrong game.
Dan came off the table from a break. That was born there.
Yes, no, I did see that. Yeah, I did see that.
Yeah, so it's not really a focus issue. It's more of a memory issue.
Yeah. When you pass 50, your memory starts deteriorating.
Bar any major slip-ups, I think this would be 8.
Yeah, they're working there, aren't
they? Yep. Just be a touch careful here. Screwing back. That's fine. I was going to say that black can cover that middle view too heavy.
I think when this black goes in, we're going to get a big shout out from the crowd. From the spectator next year.
This is looking like 8-7.
Yeah. Think he's going to get this one?
Yes. There you have it. There you go. On the hill. Going over to the Graham Bill match. Still 7-5. We will bring you the conclusion of this if the other match finishes. Bill at the table. We get to work out what colour is on, but it's looking like yellow. I think he's trying to find the angle. Really?
Sorry, we keeping you up?
Oh, yes. Is this easy on yellow? Does he flick this yellow? Yeah.
What?
So, over to you. Back to the other game.
Craig
on the hill, Dan 2 away. Which way is it going? Dan's still at 64% on the poll to win this.
Mm, yep. Craig got a yellow there from the break.
Yeah.
Okay, and then we can leave the colours as they are.
So a chance, a genuine chance here for Dan to take us to a decider. I mean, they're not easy, but you kind of feel Dan will be going.
here most definitely. Excellent effort,
played solid all night bar a couple of shots, which I think ultimately cost him. Craig took them last balls out pretty decently. Let us know in your thoughts, what you in the comments, what you made of the match. Just trying to change up the scorecard for you for the final of the plate. Bringing up a scorecard.
Great to watch and commentate.
Yep.
you can watch
the bell-end saying?
No, he was cheering you on.
Do you want to speak to your fans, Craig?
Yeah.
No.
Craig's
I've got no fans.
He's got no fans. Great game to watch. Well done, guys. Another great manager.
Right, so we've got the active scorecard
now. We've got the active scorecard, and Graham's put one back, so it's now 7-6. So that this one's going... Looks
like
it's going away as well.
I don't know.
So, Bill is on.
You know, it's on Ritter. We'll have to find out in a
second. We'll have to find out, yeah.
We can only do one thing at once. You know, technology these days.
You know, just can't get the staff these days, Jake.
So can I go back and watch it?
You can go back and watch it. Craig there wanted to go and watch his own match.
Dad's going to go home.
Exactly.
Dad's going home tonight to watch the match.
And when are we going to be drinking to the long hours?
I'm having a few beers tomorrow.
You have a few beers tomorrow night to celebrate.
No,
getting on the pile.
Got a pool match tomorrow night, and I'm hoping that Albert's got my fucking cue done by the weekend. Oh, language.
What about the language?
I've been on the other ones the other
day.
The
so nothing's changed this, do
you? No,
it's
going to
give a little turn. So,
apologies for foul language.
Cheers, mate. Good nice to meet you.
Craig
you.
Manager,
nice,
leaving
street.
The building.
Good to meet
you. You've done all the hard work, Steve.
Exactly.
besmirching my name with White Jack Productions and giving all the credits to you.
Thank you.
He's a good lad.
As I said,
Regardless of that score, Dan's still in number one, made sense for my eyes. Consistency. We took down the Ultimate Pairs tournament we won the other month.
Oh, did we?
Yeah, beating Aaron Bart and Sean Kirby in the final. That, what a, I wish we had the strength of that time, because that final, for me, was on the highest
quality. I think I played in it.
I mean, playing, brushing the tables. Different kettle of fish.
Well, I nearly knocked out Ozzy in the quarters.
He did.
Yeah.
No, but Dan and what a match! I mean, from what I remember, I think they went. Dan and Ricky went 3-0 down. Then they went 4-3 up. I think it's 4-0. And did you win the decider, Dan?
I remember doubling the naughty double.
A naughty double for the win. Yeah, it's cracking to watch. But that's the game you built. Lamy on the LAs.
Thank you very much. Now it's got the long ball, mate.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Well, the bliss of my soul, what's the
rocket? What does she do? Stay tuned in for the conclusion. So just going to start another little poll. Let's go. Who's going to win? Who wins the play? Cross your votes now. Let's see what people are saying. Graham Lambert, Stu. Right, it's Graham Lamb. We need to take that ERT off.
Graham, do you know what?
What are you doing, though? Craig Malinger and Graham Lambert.
It's my fingers.
This is
my fingers type quicker than my brain thinks.
Well, let's get that. Can we get that changed?
Oh, do you know why? I knew a guy called Graham Lambert. and I think, sorry. Technical issues again.
So just renaming Graham Lambert to his Christian name.
I'm not too sure what's going on here. Do you know what it is? Every time I type, you lean on the table and it moves, and then I press my piece.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go.
Stop. So is this going to be Bill, or would it be Graham Lambert to take?
Graham Lambert, he's a good looking guy, isn't he?
Sorry, Lamy, put in your actual name. I'm your stream, we're a comedy actor, isn't it?
Shall we have a look, see if this works?
There he is, yeah, there he is.
Mr. Lamb.
Mr. Lamb. We've lost the Ert.
7-6.
Oh, excuse me, that's a nice shot there. I was going to say Lambert, but it's now back to Lamb.
I'm sure he hasn't heard that one.
No.
I always say to him when he racks the balls, it's rack of Lamb.
Oh, good one there, good one.
I was on mute when I said that. you
missed the classic one there. I don't think he goes. I'm sure he wouldn't have left it if it went. No, he's going to go for the double.
He's powering this off the middle bag and powering it off the middle bag.
He was going.
He was.
Just called the header again.
Not overly favourable for Graham. He's got one to one. Referee Wayne Banks there.
I'm going to say no. I can't give a reason why.
Might change. Brian nails this.
does, I'll be running down the road.
Top right or middle?
Top right, got a price.
Top right.
You
see more of the pocket, which makes
the one I play.
Yeah,
yeah, that makes it nice one. Quite simple.
Is it just 7-1?
Yeah, it was 7-1.
Hawkins made it 2 stakes in the last pack.
Billy on the hilly.
Billy
on the hilly.
Don't worry about leaving it.
He's lost the
white
ball.
Huh?
Get your hand in the pocket, son. Here he is. There we are. Just a little tap here. A little tap in the middle.
Homestar
Martini.
Celebrating already. You know you won.
Sex on the beach.
Graham's absolutely got it into lead off for you. So,
that's definitely. Firstly, work this commentating.
It is.
Graham's on the break. Graham Lambert.
Graham Lambert, yeah. Made some pay off. Graham Lambert. He's playing Billy and Ray's.
Yeah. I quite like making him feel uncomfortable.
Yellows. Alright, yeah. I'll be taking yellows if there is a starter.
It's quite weird.
Yeah, I think it's going to go. Let's get the right colour set going, guys. Here we go. Bish bash bosh. Look at that. Just a click of the fingers.
Went to university to
know that. Wave of the wand.
Got a degree in it.
Orology.
Go on the yellows here. Potential to take these out to take a weight. So
every time I could just
naturally be on the one, the difficult one. He's opted for top.
ask questions.
Well, you know, I've been sitting here all night and I could use a coke, so.
Jack, come on, did you want to tell me about it?
Course management. Is that another golfing term?
I'll just give you just a few minutes with Dan. Good punch over there.
Evening.
Evening, Dan. How are we doing?
Not too bad.
Watching your game tonight. Well, it was a bit of a wobbly table.
Yeah, sorry, I nearly knocked in for it.
Yes, well, watching your going tit for tat going through. How did you? How was your feeling, Andy?
Yeah, it was a good match. Bit of a slow start, but don't know. Yeah, I love them. Sorry,
hostess with the mostest. Yeah, popping around again.
Bought me a drink. Yeah, no, it was a good match. I don't think either played particularly top form, but through spells there was some good finishes, and myself I just made a couple of mistakes at important times. I felt like I probably could have won it this evening if I played a little bit more safety, but I went in today sort of with the mindset of playing my game and going for it when I had the opportunity, because I've regretted it a few times when I haven't, so why not? Don't get away often.
No, but I think there was notably one red. I think it was 6-7-6, and I think it was a red down the bottom by the black. But, I don't know if you remember that shot at all. I think that was one spot which rattled the pockets that could have dropped in.
Yeah, the one that could have took us to the side, that was a bit of a nasty angle to get out, so I tried to hit it hard, and it rattled, and that could have pushed the potential, but yeah, I probably would have played the same shot again, but maybe better next time. Well, it was a good opportunity here. It's not the easiest last yellow to get on there. Mind you, it wasn't easy, because you needed to, but quite firm to be able to get up. Good opportunity for Larry to pull one back.
Yeah, I think. Can you see him getting his?
Larry, I don't know. No, I wouldn't say that, but situations sometimes play a part in games, don't they? When you want to play it on the hill.
Yeah, no, definitely. It's not far to go. Change there. Hang on a second. It's a technical pitch there.
Yes. It didn't say more. It was 8-7. It's a bit.
There we go. Is that? That's better. It's a technical glitch. Let's build a break on this one.
Thank you.
So just remember, people, that we've got another big money match day coming up on the 4th of May. If you fancy entering, we've got one slot for the main arena going for the 11 a.m. in the morning. Just let us know. You can let us know on the Facebook page or get in contact with myself or Adam.
I was actually interested in one, so if anyone fancies one, just let me know.
Well, there you go, people. You heard it first. If any of you fancy a game against Dan, let us know. Put it in the comments or just get in contact with us. Let's make sure I'm on the right colour sets here. Let's just switch these around. Oh, technology.
Potential freeball plant. I think we've got there. I think it's good to see from there. Not the easiest shot, but putting in good stead for the rest of the frame if he pulls it off. I'm a little bit concerned that I could really commentate on which one is good. I don't want to get told off for coaching.
No, this is a. Be assured they can't hear us down here.
Oh, okay.
We do try and sit as far away as possible. However, I'm sure they heard us on the big event on Saturday where we was shouting and laughing and joking, just how quite close to them.
Oh, really?
But
your whereabouts was it, David? Down by the dartboard?
Yeah, we set up a main arena. We had we moved table 5 down to the dartboard area.
Yeah.
And we had some wall sheets up and a nice little venue done.
Yeah. I've seen a picture from Backdrop on something. I watched a few of the phones at the beginning of the girls' match.
Yeah, so it's just some main arena set up.
Yeah.
So it was a good day by all. It's on that red there. So Paul Hayes, myself and Lee Monk. We'll have to watch this space. You never know. Is he going to go for a loss of turn here? Just a tiny bit off there. Technology, I'm clipping my microphone everywhere.
Your webcam is your mic.
Yeah, my webcam. Because of cheap headsets, which Ed's got rubbish.
Yeah, these headsets, I must say,
I've had better things in my ears.
Like yeah, I don't think you can hear anything through them. Well, yours you might. What would you be thinking if you was at the table?
Me, I'll probably be going for it. There's a good opportunity for a free ball plant at the bottom of the table. So I'd probably be playing this yellow into the middle. And then if I could get onto a plant next, I'd be going for that. It'll naturally bring the yellow and black into play again, so playing is quite a safe minded player, so I think he'll go for it if it's bang on.
And I think he's left the cap there.
Yeah. Not sure what the black here, but not really much he can do with it. Oh, where's this going?
Oh. Yeah, harder, that would have been on the way. Yeah.
Faster on the pitch that I'm looking at.
Did Sean iron those cloths? Yeah, it's got some nice balls in the open there. Nice ball in hand.
I'd be interested to see if it goes from slipping up with the black ones. I've poked around a few times and I'm not 100% sure what his decision will be here. But looking at it, it looks to me like he's going for it. Try and bother the back. Might actually go in the middle of the pond and see if it's. Yeah. I think this will be game on.
God, we've got a dog running across the arena.
Just what you want. He's a well behaved dog.
I'll spring my two down, I've got two St Bernards.
That might be a little bit different.
I did take one to a pool match once, but he does half slobber and he did slobber on the table by mistake.
Yeah, the heads are probably the height of the table. I do like big dogs myself, but expensive to run.
Yeah, they do. I think them dogs eat more than I do. So far, I'd be going for it.
Yeah.
I'm an attacking player. Black out in the open now. Yeah, straight for the middle. Little tap in it with the 8 all. Go into this.
Well, people have definitely got their value for money this evening.
Flapjacks. Yeah.
Some
people predicted this would go all the way.
They were right.
Was about to fly an helicopter off.
They saw you on there, they wanted to stop. Why is Jack Dayton service?
You wouldn't see no helicopter pilot with these headphones on.
Well, we're just wrapping up here, and Graham's going to be breaking on the
final frame in this situation. Go either way. Obviously, that's not quite sure.
This is where you don't want to dry brake or cursing with a dry brake. Oh my god, I've cursed him.
Yeah, I've cursed him. Commentator cursing. There's a very good opportunity here for Bill on the eyes. Very good opportunity. I can't see one set ball. He drifts up to the on top of the table if there's yellow in the middle. Could be getting over. But in these situations, nothing's easy.
I don't know, I think he's looking at reds.
He might be able to see a bit different than me. I can't see, which is just one red.
Yeah, Bill's calling yellows.
Just as you
said, yeah.
That was the key ball. I'm a little bit unlucky to get a full ball contact on that.
It's unlucky there, just... You coming on comms?
No.
Bit awkward bridging there, but it should.
Colin might go over the salt.
Get a penultimate price to come on comms.
Yeah, exactly. Stuck around.
So,
a very good one at that. This one, only this game, jaws and out. So I'm missing for all of them.
You must be able to see there.
You can see the top cushion. You can get a shot, but from looking at it from where I am, not sure if you can.
Go for the middle, knock the other one out, I think.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
could be. Okay, I've got the standard. I'd expect these to be gone.
Yeah, do you think of taking the money in the middle and playing into the black?
Yeah, I'm looking at it.
I think he's going to use the middle ball to get position on the back, isn't he?
I think that would go in the bottom. It's a very tricky ball to land.
Well, I think he's looking to take it back into the middle. So he's got to work this cue ball.
Coming into that yellow to go on the black.
Oh.
That could be one of his exposed
to. And he's got himself on there as well. Well, if
we know what to say.
What can you say about that?
I think lose to some flukes before, but I think that one might have been the worst bit.
Alright, so it was 9-8 to Graham, so...
good match anyway, guys. Mm-hmm. Unlucky Bill.
Well, thanks for joining us.
That's all right. No problem.
Nice having...
It wasn't the most riveting commentary you've ever had, but...
It's not nice to have a new face on the mics. But thanks very much for the commentary tonight.
No problem.
And I want to thank everyone for tuning in for another evening of MDPL Wise Jack Productions. So we are going to be here again. I'm sure we'll be here. Are we going to be here before the 4th? I'm not too sure. If not, then we're definitely going to be here on the 4th for the Big Money Day event. So get in contact if you want to be on the money events, and get in contact with either myself or Adam. Or let us know when we're down in Centuries, you can come and see us. So thanks for tuning in, and congratulations to both Graham and Craig for winning this evening. And we're going to be closing the stream now. So thanks for watching.